We will now focus on ArcSight's threat intelligence capabilities. ArcSight has taken a big leap in this domain with the launch of our Galaxy program. We have four core strengths, the most critical one being the end-to-end nature of our solution. We believe that high-quality threat intel is table stakes in today's threat landscape. That's why our Gtap Basic service is free for all ArcSight ESM customers, providing CircleMisp TI integration from day one. We also offer Gtap Plus, a premium TI service for SIM customers with a higher maturity level. Galaxy is the overall name of ArcSight's new threat program. Galaxy Community is the web portal, mostly geared towards CISOs. Galaxy Threat Acceleration Program, or Gtap, provides the threat intelligence service and will be our main focus today. Gtap has two options. Gtap Basic is a starting out-of-the-box option, providing real-time detection and response for known and well-publicized threats like Log4j, SolarWinds, etc. Gtap Plus provides a high-confidence, low-false-positive premium TI service with a fixed price subscription fee. First, let's briefly look at the Galaxy community in action. Galaxy community is threat research for CISOs, and it's open to everyone, not just ArcSight customers. Galaxy community translates the digital value chain into tangible countermeasures and deterrence methods. In a nutshell, this dynamic portal helps me answer the question, what are the risks that represent the highest impact to my business? Once I log in, I can drill down on the threats based on time period, regional risk, sector, or annualized loss expectancy, and so on. I can get more information on a threat by clicking on it, along with technical details, both high level and details such as the MITRE techniques and tactics are provided. We have periodic publications. Ransomware is one of the recent ones. Briefings and threats also contain relevant information. We'll have a short demo about how ArcSight has right-click integration to this community portal later. Gtap provides always-on, real-time, high-fidelity detection and response, turning on the autopilot mode for ArcSight from day one. It aims to attack head-on the skill shortage and talent war challenges affecting today's SOC. Let's start our demo. As the analyst, I start my day in ArcSight's Respond UI, focused on the top left incident, which always reflects the incident with the highest criticality rating for the business. In this case, we're talking about Clop ransomware on a CEO laptop. I see that this incident was created by a real-time correlation rule. We now look at the incident timeline to get more context. Our CMDB tells us that this was Joe, the CEO, a VIP user in my organization. ArcSight Respond has also automatically placed a block action on my enterprise Palo Alto Panorama firewall so that we can contain the incident. But what precisely is wrong with this URL? Why does it flag as bad reputation? We will do a manual enrichment through our Galaxy TI service mentioned earlier. Without any swivel chair, I look at the results. Wow, three threat actors and one malware campaign, all with high threat levels, but also a manual override, high confidence rating. This is the creme de la creme of threat intel coming from the ArcSight CyberAir's Galaxy service. It cannot get more high fidelity than this. However, as a new analyst, I've yet to build trust in the ArcSight TI solution, so I want a second opinion from VirusTotal, which is already available as part of the default playbooks. Okay, seven other vendors also classified this as malware. We will now look at the auto-response actions generated for this threat. One playbook has been executed twice, once manually, once automatically. Two actions have been taken on the PA Panorama Enforcement System. If we feel that this was the wrong move, or the incident has since been resolved, we can simply revert the automated changes using the rollback button. Sure enough, we now rolled back the action and our CEO can once again browse the internet. It may have proved helpful to look at some of the internals. The real-time correlation engine has multiple active lists to keep this TI data in memory, updated also in real time. I can sort by name to see the latest and greatest. I can move around to see the world from Galaxy's eyes. The latest entries in this list are from today, which highlights the real-time focus of ArcSight. Let's now look at that single URL that was related to Clop ransomware on the CEO's laptop, along with three other threat actors. We have the confidence level here, along with additional context. This is critical data for speeding up the triage. arming the analyst with all the information they may need to make a final informed decision. Time is golden. This is an insider view into our prioritization formula. If an IOC has a threat level of high, we automatically turn any correlated alert into an incident. I won't read them all, but it's important for you to see that the research that's gone into this ecosystem. Our TI platformer's choice is MISP, and we're loving it. We not only subscribe to these sources, but we also provide our unique research on top of it. Our premium TI is so high fidelity that, much like an inline IPS, some of our customers already use it in their real-time block decisions, even bypassing our ArcSight analytics engine altogether. They simply consume the Gtap Plus TI data and feed it directly to ArcSight SOAR to proactively block selected high-confidence IOCs. Another critical advantage is our 67 whitelists that belong to cloud and internet infrastructure, like VPNs and proxies, and that should never be blocked if we are to avoid a negative impact on the business. We also have introduced a kill switch into the Galaxy TI ecosystem. This ensures that we don't mistakenly block hundreds of systems if our Galaxy TI curation process mistakenly tags an excessive amount of IOCs with the manual override tag. Saving time for the analysts is our top goal. This is done through false positive reduction. Let's now talk about our free out-of-the-box Gtap Basic. Based on the public instance of the Circle MISP OSINT feed, this solution provides timely information on well-publicized threats. These entries are also kept up to date in ArcSight through the same Galaxy Smart Connector. High threat levels do exist, and we take those ones most seriously. In this case, it seems a Brazilian bank's domain name was hijacked. Let's now click on this other event with an APT tag. As expected, it has the high threat level. Only high priority IOCs can result in critical or urgent incidents, while medium and low IOCs play a supporting role but without triggering an incident by themselves. We'll now look at a log4j event. Picking a medium event, we almost know where we're going with this. As expected, another false positive warning. This is in parallel with our priority decision process, like described in the previous example. Now, let's look at how quick this system is when it comes to publicly announced threats and vulnerabilities. For log4j, IOCs were imported into the public instance of Circle MISP within minutes on that fateful day, December 10th, 2021. With our real-time integration, it also came straight to our servers, and subsequently downloaded to the customer's environment with AutoSync within 1 hour of the original announcement. This ends our demo. Thank you.